السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته and greetings to all of you. Applying for medicine and really just university in general can feel like an overwhelming and really long process with all the different procedures, forms to fill, regulations, and not to forget the uncertainty that comes with applying for university and especially medicine to be more specific, or really just the healthcare field. So over the past year, actually more than a year, being in gap year as well as applying to universities, I have learned a few lessons which I think from my personal experience, which I think will be helpful, inshallah, God willing, to you if you are a potential future med student and you're looking into applying to universities. So this will be a long one, just a warning, so you might as well grab yourself a cup of tea or a coffee or really anything, and hopefully listen to it, inshallah. I hope, God willing, this is beneficial to you. So my points lessons are not in any specific order to begin with. They're just points that I've put out from my experience and that I think need to be addressed. So number one is start researching early. I cannot emphasize this enough. I think it is really important that you research universities and programs and degrees early. So my recommendation is try researching before your A-levels even start. So before you pick your A-level subjects. So roughly around once you're done with your IGCSEs or your O-level examinations, try to do some research into what you want to do. So talking about medicine in specific, look into universities and the different degrees they offer and programs. I think it'll be really helpful for you, and have a list of potential universities you want to apply to. It can even be 10, 20, just have a list that's narrowed down for you. And this makes sure that you have ample time to make the right choices, to meet admission requirements, and overall have a smooth application process in general when you do when the time does come for you to apply. Number two, make sure when you're researching to check the A-level requirements or qualifications that the university needs. Some universities may not even require you to do an A-level. Maybe you can go in with a foundation year, so you might as well check that out as well. If you think you want to skip A-level and do foundation. But for medicine generally, I think they do prefer you doing A-levels because it's an additional qualification. Before you choose your A-level subjects, make sure you look into what subjects your specific university or medical program is interested in. So some universities will require you, now obviously biology and chemistry, it's kind of like default, you do need to do those subjects to get into medicine in most universities. Some universities will require you to do physics in specific, whereas most universities are okay with either a physics or a maths A-level. Moreover, also do make sure you inquire and get acquainted with the sitting. So this was something that I had personally experienced, and I will definitely emphasize this the most in this video. If you're taking away one thing, you might take this lesson with you, is that make sure you check with them if you have to do your A-level subjects in one sitting, because some countries, some universities, they require you to do your A-level subjects in one and the same sitting. Now what we mean by this is that you have obtained all of your passes, so all of your exams, in one and the same sitting. So what this ideally means is that at the end of your A-level, you will have a certificate, so your transcript with your final grades. All the grades, all your subjects should be in one certificate. Now this is, some universities don't really specify anything like, this type of a rule, but some universities or some countries, they do specify. Some universities may also require you to do a specific number of subjects. Mostly 90% of the time, you are good to go if you've done 3 A-level subjects. I think some universities may specify you to do 4. It really just depends. So I would say that try to research and get information on that as well. So if you are doing A-level, you've chosen the pathway of doing AS and A2. That is basically you do three subjects, you cover half of it in the first year, which is AS, and you cover the second half in A2, and you give your final A-level exam in the second year. Then you should not, it shouldn't be an issue because you will get your three grades and your three subjects in one certificate. But if your school does offer a one-year A-level program, which I don't think is very common, but anywho, if it does offer it, where you complete all your exams in 1 year, so normally how this happens is you do two subjects, you complete the two subjects in the first year completely, you do not break it into you know, AS and A2, and in your second year you do two other subjects, so you do four subjects in total. In this case you will have two certificates with four grades, so two of your subjects will be in the first certificate and two in your second certificate. Now this option or this pathway doesn't fall under the category of all your passes in one and the same sitting, because your subjects would be spanned out over two certificates. So be very careful with this. If you are a Sri Lankan in specific watching this, my recommendation is do not go for 1 year A-level pathway, because Sri Lanka does have a rule that they need all your subjects in one certificate. I myself faced this issue, so it's something that I would recommend you to be really careful of. Next one is a research other key information, or look into other key information. So when you're looking at a university, a potential program, number one, research all your options. Medicine is not just MBBS, it's not just MD, right? There's a lot of different programs and degrees that are offered. So make sure you are exploring all your options, right? There's a lot of, there's a wide array of fields in medicine itself, and degrees and undergrads and postgrads. So make sure you are researching and exploring all your options. Look into key information with every single university. So look into the program duration. I think that's something that's really important to look into, right? How long is that undergrad degree? And look into the pathway. So different countries have different education process and steps to becoming a licensed physician. Like, for example, if you're in like India or Pakistan or Sri Lanka, you know, you can do a 5-year undergrad MBBS and you can get licensed to become a physician and you can practice. In some countries, as far as my knowledge goes, don't quote me on this, but you can do your own research in this case, like UK or the US or Canada or even Australia, you are required to do an undergrad bachelor's of science in a subject, so major in a biology, chemistry, or even other subjects. You're required to do an undergrad, and then you're required to, and then you can get into med school and, you know, study medicine and become a licensed physician. So that pathway would be different. Again, this is something that I recommend you do your own research and be informed about the process in a country that you're looking into, right? Especially if you're an international, if you're going into it as an international student. Do make sure you just, you know, have a look at the structure of the program. So how are their preclinicals, their the clinicals, all of that, what are the facilities and the standard of education as well, because it's medicine, you want to go for a good you know, standard of education as well. Also make sure you're checking or you're looking into the application process in itself. So, you know, are you required to give an entrance exam? So some countries, some universities will require you to do an actual entrance exam. As far as my knowledge goes, I think UK universities, you need to do the UK CAT exam. You need to do SATs for certain countries, like I think Pakistan or India. If you are applying for government universities, you might be required to sit for an exam. And also most universities, some of them, or most of them actually, require you to do an English qualification, right? So the IELTS or TOEFL. So these are all information that will be really helpful for you, right? If you research and get early, so you can prepare for them accordingly. You might also, it'll also be really helpful for you to look into the personal statements. Does your university require you to write a personal statement? And personal statements are, It is very unique to you. It's something that requires time and effort, right? To work on. So personally, I never wrote a personal statement because my universities that I applied to never required one. But I think it's a really good idea to have a look at that in case you have to write one. And also, it'll be a good idea to have a look at the interview type. So, does your university require you to attend an interview, and what type will it be? Is it a face-to-face interview where you just have a discussion, or is it an MMI, which are multiple mini interviews? They are different, and I think it's a good idea to kind of get a grasp on all these application, steps that are required, so you're not just, lost when you're actually applying. One important thing, another really, really important thing actually, is get acquainted with the application deadlines. So, most universities obviously have their timeline for application. So, make sure you start applying as soon as it is open, just so you have enough time to deal with any uncertain factors that come in the way, and it's smooth for you, and you're not freaking out with less time. Make sure you are thinking long term. So look into or inquire if the information is not given. Most inquire about internships upon graduation. So this is specifically if you're an international student. Some countries, like example Malaysia, they don't give you internship. So basically, in medicine, you don't just study 5 years, get a degree, and become a doctor. No, that's not how it works. You study your undergrad, and after your graduation, upon graduation, you do have to go into internship. Some countries call it housemanship, and there's also residency. So it's a good idea to check with the university about the internship opportunities and how it is done and the process in that country. So for example, Malaysia, if you're an international student, they don't provide you with internship. So once you're done with your 5 years, you are required to return to your home country, and in your home country, you do your internship and you get licensed in your country and you practice in your country. So I think this is another really, really important key thing to look into when you're applying for medicine. Make sure you are acquainted with post grad, after your graduation, what's going to happen? So, where will you do internship? Will they allow you to do internship in that country? And what are the requirements? For really important aspect of application, I would say, is get networking. Meet up with your career counselor. As far as my knowledge goes, a lot of schools have career counselors who are more than willing to help you with the application process and just, getting acquainted with the different options and applications. So talk to your career counselor. She or he will help you with the applications and make it smooth. And they will also give you important information as well and guide you throughout the whole process. You can also talk to your seniors who are already in universities, how their experience is, and they will also help you out. And another really important tip, I would say, something that's really helpful, is email and contact the university themselves. There's always a representative who's willing to give you all the information you want, who's willing to guide you through the application and beyond as well. So it's a really good idea to email them and contact them with, all the queries that you have. So all of this will really just help you make an informed decision. Another tip I would say, now this is just generally really, is create a drive on your computer or even a Google Drive, and have all your documents, required transcripts and certificates and even passport copies in one place. So scan it and store all of them in one place, organized neatly. This makes it a lot easier for you to apply to many universities. So let's say you're applying to multiple universities, it'll be easy for you to send across your documents. And it also keep and make sure you're keeping them up to date as well. Now, talking about applying to multiple universities, I know now it is important that you have a wide array of options to choose from. So I would recommend, yes, apply to multiple universities, right? Because you never know what university you will get into, and it gives you a good a range of options to choose from later on. But at the same time, don't just go around applying to 5, 10 universities for prestige sake. Don't just apply for the sake of applying. It's nice to say that I got into 5 universities, or I got into 6 programs, I got into Harvard or Cambridge. But don't just apply for the sake of applying, right? At the end of the day, you're only going to be studying in one university, right? Whether you got into 10 or 20, nobody cares about that. At the end of the day, you're going to be studying in one university. So be conscious about your application and your choices that you're making. Application does come with its own fees. So I would say narrow it down to 5 or 6, so it'll be really helpful for you later, but don't overdo it. Talking about medicine again in specific, all be conscious about your finances as well, because obviously medicine is an expensive degree and it's long term, right? So it's a good idea to look into that as well when you are looking into universities. There are scholarships available, so do research on different scholarships available and look them up. They do give scholarships no matter what your grade. It doesn't mean that you need to have an A star or A. But I will say that there are very few for medicine, so that's something to keep a note of. When it comes to grades in A level, for medicine, my recommendation is aim for an A star to B. Try not to go beyond a B. If you do, it's fine, don't worry about it. But I would say aim for an A star to B, because it just makes it a lot less stressful later when you're applying to universities, because you will know you have a high chance. Now, this point, the next point is kind of general as well, but the point is don't go into medicine or apply to a specific university in a specific country for the sake of friends or, your company. Make sure you're applying to a university or a program because you want to, and make sure you're applying to it with, conscious reasons and you've thought it out properly. So, another thing, the next point is also regarding medicine being a long journey. Studying medicine is a long time. Your basic undergrad degree will be minimum for 5 years or 6 years, right? So when you're choosing your university or the country you want to study in, it should be a country or a place you don't mind living and practicing medicine in, because where you study, you get licensed in that country, right? And you practice in that country. So be really cautious of that as well, right? Because you will be licensed and you'll be expected to practice in that country once you do your internship there. So be mindful of that as well, I think, when you're applying for university. It's a good factor to consider. Now, my last point, I hope I've covered all my points. I feel like I've just been rambling. The last point is, now this is not something for every single person out there, it's just a tip, right? Is that if you can afford to, if you are able to, do try to visit the university you're looking into. So I had the opportunity to visit a few universities that I wanted to apply to, so I did. And what benefit you get from this is when you visit a university, normally they are more than willing to give you all the information firsthand. They're more than willing to take you around the university campus as well. So it's really great for you to check out their facilities. So when it comes to medicine, do they have a cadaver lab? How are their, anatomy labs? How are their libraries? What are the facilities available? Where is the clinicals going to be held? All of that and the system of teaching, how it goes, all of this is, it's really helpful when you see it firsthand. And you also get acquainted with the surroundings and the environment, as well as the student community there. So it is really helpful. Again, this is not something I would say like you have to do. It's just something if you can, then it'll be really helpful for you to make an informed decision at the end of the day. So I think that sums up all of my points I have written down. So to conclude, I would say that keep your options open always. Apply with an open mind. Don't just be fixed on one specific course and one specific university or country. be open, be flexible, right? In case things take a turn, not everything goes how you want it perfectly, right? The real world doesn't work that way. For some of you, application might be really smooth. For some of you, it might not, and that's okay. So that's my advice. If you are a med student watching this, or you're a student in university, and if you have any lessons that you would like to share regarding applications, let us know in the comments down below, and I'll make sure to share it as well. And for any of the points or lessons that I've mentioned in this video, if you do differ with them, do let me know. I would really appreciate it. And yeah, so that's basically this post. Quite different for me and very new. Nonetheless, I hope you've benefited from it, and I hope the lessons and that I've learned from the mistakes I've made will help you have a more smooth and stress-free application process. Do feel free to share this video around to anyone you think will benefit from it. And yeah, so see you guys next time.